After a bipartisan group of senators reached an agreement on the framework of a $1 trillion infrastructure bill Wednesday, the legislation moved one step closer to reality when the Senate voted to advance that bill. So let me bring in now what this prospective bill could mean for American workers. Secretary of Labor Marty Walsh, Mr. Secretary, thank you for being here with us. And whether they're in Memphis or Albuquerque, whether they're in Texas or Oregon, tell every American what this could mean for them if this thing gets into place.
Yeah, this bill, this infrastructure framework, the bipartisan infrastructure framework, is really game changing for the country. It allows us the opportunity to continue to make investments in our physical infrastructure here, in roads and bridges all across America, in broadband access in rural America that might not have broadband access, clean drinking water, money into airports and ports around this country for goods and services coming in and out of our country. This is electric grids, power stations, investments in electric buses, investment in commuter rail, and public transportation. So when you think about it, it's if you're sitting at home, it's about any connectivity that you have, whether it's through computer or physical roads. They're going to make a $1.3 trillion investment. It's the largest single investment in our country in about a century. So when you think of it, that's how big and dynamic this can be.
Secretary Walsh, you listed several things, items that are probably going to be in that final bill that's going to be voted on. And it's a lot maybe for you and for the president, for Americans, you would say, to be excited about. But what jumps out at you? What particular provision in there are you particularly excited about getting in the legislation?
I personally think one of the biggest investments in this is with broadband. I think that in clean drinking water, we still have, you know, thousands and thousands of pipes in this country that are lined with lead. So I think getting rid of lead pipes finally in the United States of America in the 21st century is important. But I think the biggest game changer is broadband. When the coronavirus hit us about 18 months ago, many people were sent home to work from home, and all children were sent home to learn from home. They didn't have the good connectivity. Having an internet and having the ability for people to be able to connect to educational opportunities is going to be changing. It can change the trajectory of a whole family.
Have to bring up what, of course, President Biden talked about this week, in that federal workers, he wants them to either prove that you're vaccinated, or if you're not, you're going to be subjected to a once or twice a week possible testing and safety protocols. You're still resisting, and some of the unions, I think you didn't get too much resistance, but there's resistance to a mandate. Do you think this is a good compromise, and have you consulted with the federal worker unions about what's going to be the final policy in place?
I haven't had any conversations per se. The president came out with this the other day. But I will say this. I mean, when you think about where we are with the coronavirus, at the beginning of the summer, you know, we were lifting mask mandates. Restaurants were opening. Tourism spots were opening. People were starting to go back to work. We all felt pretty good. I think a lot of people thought we were beyond this point. As the variant started to rise, we're seeing people that are unvaccinated getting coronavirus. We're seeing people who are unvaccinated in serious conditions in the hospital. News reports all across the country are talking about it. It's really, really important that we get people vaccinated. Our economy, our small businesses can't take much more of this type of restrictions that we could potentially have to do again. And I would just encourage everyone, please get vaccinated. For some reason, this turned into a political issue. The vaccines, it's not a political issue. This is an issue. The scientists and science is showing that if you get vaccinated, you're less likely to get coronavirus. And if you get coronavirus, you're less likely to have serious side effects from it. We're asking people to get vaccinated. And quite honestly, to come back to the workforce, if people aren't going to get vaccinated, then they're going to get tested often once we open up fully to get people back into the building. We have to, because we want to protect our workers, we want to protect our workforce, and we want to stop the spread of the virus.
All right, Secretary of Labor Marty Walsh, I know you are out there. You are on a road trip talking about this infrastructure plan and also those safe workplaces. So good luck on the rest of that road trip. I know you're going to be making a stop in New York. Maybe we'll see you here. But thanks so much for your time.
Thank you.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.